All right, guys, it's Stephen here on BlueMoonRisingTV, and this is the transfer target. We're going to be doing loads of business this summer with all the transfer gossip. It's going to be here. So hit subscribe below and also turn on the notifications so you don't miss out on any news on any potential signings, because it's going to be a busy summer, let's be honest. But let's get going on the first name, and it's a new one from yesterday, and it's Alexandra Zinchenko. Now, I'll be honest with you, I hadn't heard about him until yesterday either, but these ones are quite exciting. Every time you hear a new name mentioned that you've never heard before, you have to wonder why. It isn't a PR thing, it isn't a sell papers, because he's not selling papers in the UK, let's be honest. So there may be something to this. I think this is quite a positive move, and I think there will be a lot more about this in the coming weeks. The rumours are that we're going to be signing after the summer. If you don't know, which is understandable, he's a young 19-year-old midfielder who seems to be able to play anywhere. He can play fullback, weirdly. He can play left wing, right wing, attacking midfielder, defensive midfielder. He seems very elegant, a little bit like De Bruyne, the way he runs. As a winger, when he's out on the right, he seems to be a little bit Patrick Roberts-esque, and he very much seems to be one for the future. Now, this is very much fits Pep's remit. We all know what he's like. He turned Kingsley Coman into one of the best young wingers in the world. And I wouldn't be surprised if we put a few million on this young lad and hopefully see a potential future investment from him. He isn't expected to be a star straight away, but that doesn't necessarily matter. So I actually think this will happen. I think there's too much there. A lot of people reporting it. It initially came through a Russian website, but now Goal reporting it amongst others, and the MEN have gotten it and so on. So I'm going to move this one pretty much kind of in between the middle and the outer rings, because I think we'll see him become a City player. He might get loaned out eventually, but he'll become a City player, I think. The second name, and this is one a few of you have been asking about, is Hector Bellerin. Now, we all know Arsenal players, for whatever reason, love coming to Manchester City, and this could be another one. It's pretty obvious that we need a right back at the moment. Pablo Zabaleta, as much as we love him, isn't getting any younger. He seems to be on his last legs at Man City, and there's big rumours that he could be leaving too. And Bakary Sagna, despite having a good season, isn't any younger either. So Bellerin, 21, ex-Barcelona academy prospect, off the back of a great season at Arsenal, Spanish. He ticks all the boxes, very modern fullback, a lot of pace, a lot of tenacity. And it was the Times that were reporting this as well, and they're a pretty reputable source of this kind of thing. So I think the interest is real. Guardiola knows that we need to totally overhaul our fullbacks, both left and right hand sided. And Bellerin, very fast, very skillful, great technique. He fits that. I don't think we're close yet on this, because I think this is the kind of transfer that would go on all summer, because Arsenal wouldn't lose their new number one right back without a fight. So I'm going to kind of put it on the outer rings for now. But this is definitely one to keep an eye on, because we need defensive reinforcements and he certainly fits the bill. The final name for today is Aymeric Laporte. Now, if you don't know if you saw it, but Cal Doon, our wonderful chairman, talked last night to one of City's reporters, and during that interview they said that we've completed one deal, which is obviously Gundogan, and another is very close. The rumour is that this is Aymeric Laporte. City have allegedly activated his £39 million release clause, and he just fits what City want perfectly. He is the archetypal Pep defender. He's very elegant, very composed, great on the ball. He's a big lad as well. He's 6'2", he has a decent turn of pace. I know people are saying he's got injury problems at the moment, but there's already footage of him online on his personal Twitter, running and dribbling with the ball. So he's making a very good recovery. I think we're going to see a massive overhaul of our defensive positions. We'll all probably agree that Demichelis is well on his way out of the club. Mangala and Otamendi weren't at their very best, and company has injury problems. So Laporte, I think, isn't going away. And there's rumours that that could be completed before the Euro start as well. So that's our three there. I'm going to move him in a little bit from the outer rings, because I think he's very close to City and we could see big movements on that pretty soon. But yeah, what do you reckon to those, Blues? Any of those three do you see coming into City next season? And who do you want to see discussed in future episodes as well? Is Laporte the answer to our defensive problems? As I was saying before, if you haven't already, subscribe below and you'll get all updates on all things Man City, all things gossip and transfers anyway. And drop a like on the video too, and we'll see you tomorrow for another transfer target.